Hello, beautiful people. I am just doing a quick vlog. I literally just got out of the shower and cleansed my face, and I'm just thinking about some things on my mind. I just thought I would do a quick vlog as I am just prepping my skin right now. And of course, I have to use my own skincare products. So to find out more about the Inez Elizabeth Beauty skincare line, please go to the links in the description box to support my brand and to support your skin. In the process right now, I'm going to be moving one of my business locations, and I'm excited about it, but I'm also nervous a little bit. You know, with a move, it's always, you know, it's a good bit of work. And I have been in the current building that this business location has been in for over 10 years. So it's been a long time that I've been in this building, but I'm grateful that things are working out the way they are, because when I had the thoughts about moving the location, I started looking actually in late 2020, and I'm just sending somebody a text message as I speak. Anyway, I'm moving my location, and the building that I'm currently in, the lease doesn't end on it until next year in 2023. But because technically breaking my lease, which I really didn't have a problem with doing, I started looking for a space in late 2020, and the space that my second business location is in right now, at the time when I found it in 2021, I thought I was going to be moving that location then, and I really just felt in my spirit that I wasn't supposed to be doing that. I was supposed to keep that location open. And then as time just, you know, continued to move on, that's when I started feeling the urge to start looking for a space again to move the location. And I had a few spaces in mind. One space was new construction, and it would have worked out well. It wasn't far from where we currently are, but I was actually, I was in the process of waiting for the property manager's office to get back with me, because they said they were waiting on some things, but they really liked my business and the use of the space, but we're still waiting. So in the meantime, as I waited, I continued to look, and I saw this one space, and it was in a really great area, great visibility. And I, you know, reached out to the realtor that's helped me to find spaces, and he said, because he was still sending me spaces to look at, and I said, hey, this one looks interesting, can we check it out? And we did, and long story short, everything worked out. So I got the space, and so I'll be moving into that space effectively next month. But I got the keys today. They gave me the keys early, so that was a plus. So I'm hopefully going to be able to start getting the work done in the building this month instead of next month, which will be spectacular, because next month, not only are we moving, but I have someone else that will be moving into the space that we're moving out of. I'll be subleasing it to a friend and colleague, and she's also a licensed cosmetologist. She does my hair when I do go and get my hair professionally done, which, to be honest with you, is not very often. So I don't see her very often. So everything just worked out. When I was telling her about the space, when I went to go get my hair done with her, I got some hair extensions done in August. My birthday was in August, and I wanted to do that for myself. I started telling her about the fact that I was going to be moving, and she said, well, you know, I've been looking for a space in the area, but I just haven't been able to find anything. And I said, well, So she wanted to check it out. She checked it out, and to shorten the story, I said, look, if you're interested in it, I can reach out to the landlord, because of course it's not my space. I don't want to do anything under the table, and I want to make sure everything is on the up and up for you, because I would not want to put you in a position where it would jeopardize your moving from where you currently are to come there. So I spoke to her, the landlord, and she, landlord slash owner of the building, and she said, you know what, Elizabeth, you've been an amazing tenant. You've been great over the years. I have not had any problems with you. So whatever you want to do, I'm okay with that. I said, okay, cool. So I let her know that everything was a go. She sent me the, like, you know, praise hands emoji back via text. And so that's working out. So I have someone that's going to be moving into the space and taking it over. And I'm really happy for her because it's actually her first time having her own building. She's only ever, I don't want to say only, but she's previously either rented a booth in another salon or she's had a salon suite. But this will be like her own building. And I believe it'll actually be like the same amount of rent that she's paying for a suite right now that she would be paying for her own building. So it'll give her the opportunity to grow her business where she can bring other people on board and help to grow her business. So for me, that was really a plus and a blessing. So I'm really excited for her. And anytime I can help someone else out, which is pretty much what I've done the majority of my career as a business owner, I am happy to do it. Have I always been treated right after helping people out? No, of course not. But we live in that's the type of world we live in, where not everyone is going to think of others and be grateful. A lot of people are self-absorbed, self-centered, I'm just looking out for myself, gotta go for mine, you go for yours, that type of thought. And it's very selfish, but I don't operate that way. So I do believe that even though some negative things have happened in my life, that's one of the reasons why God really just allows things to work out for me ultimately, because I never make it just about myself. So with all that being said, I'm having an event at my second location. And for me, it has been something that has been something I've had a phobia or anxiety about with, and it's crazy because dealing with imposter syndrome, which is, you know, one of the things I've discussed before on my channel, and one of the things that I've recognized that I have dealt with in my career as a business owner with imposter syndrome, you have thoughts of you're not good enough, you're not worthy, just a lot of different things to make you feel like you're inferior and you don't deserve to have what you have to be where you are, or even if you're not where you want to be yet, you don't deserve to get there. Well, as I would say, as a young teen mom, I can remember having the thoughts of not wanting to have birthday parties for my son because I didn't want to send invitations out to people, invite people, and I had thoughts that people would not show up. And I don't know why I thought that way, because it wasn't anything that I've ever said or done to anyone to make anyone feel that way, but I just never did it. And it was something that I had within me. So I didn't have birthday parties for our son when he was younger. We would, you know, get him, I don't say whatever he wanted, but we would just like get him gifts and, you know, and celebrate with him, you know, within our own little small circle, but not having a full-on birthday party where I was inviting a lot of other people, his friends from school and, you know, and other people around. And it was because of those thoughts that I had. And that is something that has traveled with me into my life as an adult and as a business owner, where I didn't really want to have an event in my business because I was nervous about feeling like, well, what if no one shows up? What if we do all of this and nobody comes? And that phobia, that anxiety, it is real. But I'm challenging myself. So we're having a holiday event at one of my business locations next month. And I had to really just like step into the faith of all of the years that I have been in business and all of the people that have shown up for my business, where I've had multiple locations. I still do. I just don't have as many as I used to anymore. And that's fine. But the business has done exceptionally well over all of the years that I have been in business. And people showed up for the business, which is essentially, you know, I'm a part of it. It's something I birthed. and has not been easy, but people have shown up. So why would I have those thoughts, the phobias and the anxiety about having an event for my business where I've been getting business locations and having to pay rent and utilities and taxes and all the like literal financial obligations and responsibilities and risks that I've taken on to hope and pray that people would show up for my business to support. So why would I be nervous about having an event for my business where I really just want to celebrate and celebrate people and celebrate the business and celebrate the holidays? The imposter syndrome, because it is really asinine to, you know, to think that way. But I said, you know what? At first, I said I need to have somebody else to do this event for me, to plan it out, to prepare, to invite those in the community and surrounding and the clientele and all those different things. And people were flaking. So the imposter syndrome was rising up a bit again because I started to take it personally, where it was like, well, I've asked this person to help me to do this and I was gonna pay them. I was waiting to get a quote and an estimate and I never heard back. And the thoughts just started rising up again to make me feel like, well, maybe it's me. Maybe they don't wanna work with me. Maybe they don't think, you know, my business is worth it or worthy, the imposter syndrome. And then I had to like chuck that away from me and said, screw that. Why am I running after someone to pay them to do a job for me that we, as myself and my team as a whole, we could do together? So I said, it's all good. We're just going to get some bottles and, you know, get some platters and get some decor, get the flyer made, send it out to the, you know, different areas, the clientele, the community. And that's a wrap. And whoever shows up, shows up. But I refuse to operate in this mindset of feeling inferior or not worthy or whatever. All of those different thoughts were coming up within me to make me feel like I couldn't do this or nobody would support. And even with me doing this video, and not just this video, but me even having a YouTube channel, I had to dismantle the imposter syndrome to say that there's somebody that is interested in what I have to share. And I can't operate in that way or it's going to hold me back. And because I've gotten comments and messages from people who have shared with me that things that I have shared with those who are subscribed to or not subscribed yet. And if you're not subscribed yet, please do go ahead and subscribe to my channel and watches and listens and takes in the content that I share with you all here, how it has helped them or impacted them in some way positively or what I said they really needed to hear. So I'm grateful for that. So I'm glad that I did not allow imposter syndrome to hold me back in that area, because if I did, then I wouldn't have even started this YouTube channel when I did. And I actually started it over because I started it previously. I grew it on my own to, gosh, I don't even know how many subscribers I did. And then I started it over. I started another channel and I did something else with that channel. I just kind of turned it into something different and rebranded it. So imposter syndrome is something that is constantly there, but I have to make the decision to say I'm not going to allow that to hold me back and say, okay, yeah, I see you, but I'm not going to allow you to stop me. So we're having this event. I'm grateful to say that I'm going to do it. I got the keys to the location that we'll be moving into next month early. How often does that happen? So I'm really excited about that. And I am just in a really good space right now mentally. I've been doing my best with coping and helping my husband with his issues with the PTSD, and also just continuously checking in on my mom and my dad, because I shared with you all about him being missing for a little over a week, and it definitely was, you know, due to his addiction to drugs. I'm not going to go off into that, you know, talking more about that right now, but in spite of all of those things, I'm just really grateful to say that I'm in a good headspace right now. My spirit is definitely lifted. I've been spending more time just reading things that are encouraging me, whether it's scriptures that are really helping to remind me of who God created me to be, spending more time and just praying and releasing my anxieties and my worries, just letting it go to God and say, God, you got me. You're, you know, the enemy to my worries. So thank you for fighting my battles for me. And that feels really good to know that that's exactly what, you know, God will do for me. That's what I believe. So I'm home right now, not sure what's going on with the weather because we are actually under a tropical storm watch right now. And it happened so quickly. Just like, I don't want to cancel anyone that's on the schedule for tomorrow yet, but I just have to kind of see how it goes, because when it comes to tropical storms and low level hurricanes like one or whatever, I mean, I would never go into the business and see clients if we're under a hurricane watch. When it comes to a tropical storm warning or watch like we're under right now, when the path of the storm seems to be pretty wide and they say, you know, it doesn't really have like a strong eye or center, then it's possible that you could just still go into work. And if the clients show up, great. If they don't, we get it. We'll just get them rescheduled. But I hate to cancel things because of that, but I'm definitely going to stay safe and watch as well as pray to make sure that I'm doing the right thing, because there's nothing like driving on the road and then you feel that like one whiff of wind that feels like it's going to like lift your car up off the road. I've been there before. That does not feel good. That's a scary feeling. And it's crazy how when you're driving, if you're used to like driving with one hand, and as when something like that happens, you put both hands on the wheel as if putting both hands on the wheel is going to stop your car from doing whatever the wind is going to cause it to do. But you know how that is. We just do things subconsciously. And it is what it is, but I'm going to end this video here. I hope you all are doing amazing. Just want to do a quick vlog while I had a little bit of time and share with you guys what, you know, just a few things that I've been dealing with, things that are going on in my mind, things that I'm just kind of realizing and things that I'm overcoming. And that's the most important thing that I want to do here on this channel with you guys. It's not to sit and complain and moan and talk about woe is me, I'm going through this, I'm going through that. I hope you get from me what I'm sharing with you is that even though I'm going through some things, I'm going through them. I'm continuing to move forward. I'm not standing still. I'm not retreating and going backwards. I'm not quitting. I'm not stopping. I'm going through it and I'm overcoming. So that's what I want you all to get from me that I share with you all on this channel. It's about, yes, I am going through some things, but I am determined to overcome them. So thank you guys so much for checking out this video. I really appreciate you subscribing to the channel. And if you haven't already done so, go ahead and subscribe. Go ahead and hit that like button. And so until the next time, I am the Minister of Beauty and I share the Bible. That is business, inspiration, beauty, life, and enjoyment. So until the next time, I hope you all stay safe and have an amazingly blessed and beautiful day.